Hello everyone, welcome back to another edition of the All About Apps from the Cleveroad Studio. Today we're going to talk about app distribution. Specifically, we are looking at alternative app stores. Let's find out whether they are worthy of your attention. You might be wondering why it's necessary to consider placing your app into an alternative app store, rather than just using the official ones at all. Well, the answer is simple. It will help you spread the word and make potential customers aware of your product faster. Nevertheless, I don't recommend regarding them as an absolute means of user acquisition. Just like everything else, such stores have their advantages and disadvantages. Let's look at the question in more detail. For your reference, I have arranged a list of the most popular alternatives. Let's go through them one by one and point out the main pros and cons. We start with Amazon. It basically offers applications for devices of the same name. However, you can download such apps if your phone or tablet works with Android. The following components make up the pros of the store: an effective verification process and app security. Exclusive apps which are not available anywhere else. One free app on a daily basis. Services for developers to pre-test their apps before uploading them to the store. A free trial period to use the applications before purchasing them. A wide geographic coverage that extends to over 200 countries and territories. For the cons, you should note that Amazon has far fewer applications than Google Play, and it takes quite a lot of time to approve updates. We're now moving on to the next store, which is called SlideMe. There, you can find both free and paid for applications. The pros of the store are as follows. PayPal and Amazon can be used for transferring money into a SlideMe wallet. A developer's account provides additional tools. The approval procedure ensures that only apps of the appropriate quality and content are accepted. For the cons, remember that the SlideMe website may not display the complete data and the process of verification is longer. Our next point is LG SmartWorld, an app store alternative that, as the name implies, is geared towards LG devices. The pros include: it has specially designed themes for LG devices, the ability to use different payment methods, useful recommendations for users, and helpful services for developers. The main con is the strict connection with LG devices. We proceed now to the Samsung Galaxy Store, which offers applications sharpened for particular Android devices. The benefits lie in supporting developers by means of a special SDK and tools, unique apps which are not available in other stores, apps that are compliant with the material design and the availability in multiple countries. Despite its popularity, the number of applications in the Samsung Galaxy Store is much less than the official Android Store. The next store to consider is Uptodown. It offers both web and mobile applications and extends to different operating systems such as Android, iOS, and Windows Phone. The list of advantages include: there is no country restriction. It is for free apps only. Available in multiple languages, a unique description for each app, and it has powerful security measures. A major disadvantage concerns the presence of banned apps coming from Google Play. The point is that such applications might be to some extent dangerous for customers since the official Android store has denied them. Our last entry in the list of alternative stores for today is APKMirror. It offers applications designed for Android. The pros to consider are the ability to access older app versions, the chance to get beta app versions, no registration, which simplifies the process of app downloading, connection with Google Play, that is, when you attempt to download an app, APKMirror checks whether it is the same as the one in the official store. The main disadvantage to bear in mind, it is not a native Android store. This means that the only way to download an application is via the APKMirror website. On the subject of alternative stores, we must make mention of stores based in China. This market has many disadvantages, since some developers might find their applications offered in different places, but, of course, the money goes somewhere else. However, the fact that Google Play is not available in China, despite an impressive number of potential users, makes it a good reason for paying attention to this area. Well, it's time to decide whether alternative stores are the right choice for you or not. As usual, the question can't be answered with a simple yes or no. To make a sound decision, remember the main benefit you get is an increase in the potential customer base. However, the biggest risk you face is the one of being hijacked, especially in the Chinese stores. That's all for today. To discover more alternative stores and explore the subject in more detail, click the article link below. Bye for now, and please don't forget to subscribe.